Then I talk about kinematic chain. What kinematic chain is basically its definition. I explain you this kinematic chain with the example of a slider crank mechanism. Then we seen the chain can be called as a simple or compound kinematic chain. When it is simple kinematic chain, when it is compound kinematic chain, based on number of links it has. Then we classified it into two types, that is open and closed kinematic chain. Further, closed kinematic chain is classified in two types, that is simple closed chain and compound closed kinematic chain. At the last, we discussed concept of mechanism and linkage, in which whenever in a kinematic chain one of the link is fixed, then we call it as a linkage. But when in a linkage, if you give motion to one of the link and if you obtain a different motion of other link, then that linkage is known as a mechanism. Also, we talk about, even though this clear distinction is there, but it is hardly followed, and each can be referred in place of others. That what also we discuss about mechanism and linkage. Then when you talk about mechanism, there are two types of mechanisms, that is simple mechanism and compound mechanism. So if a mechanism with four links is known as simple mechanism, while mechanism with more than four links is known as a compound mechanism. Okay, this is what all about last lecture. So today we are going to start with new topic, that is nothing but a Grashof's law. Actually, I have to discuss concept of kinematic chain in more detail, but for that PPT is not sufficient. So I will take that lecture on a board. Okay, so I skip that topic now, that is kinematic chain in detail way. Means when a kinematic chain, I define kinematic chain, but there are some few examples, numericals we have to take based on kinematic chain. For that, I'll use some other methodology, not PPT. So we'll shift to next topic, that is Grashof's law. What basically this Grashof's law is, remember this law is defined to obtain one particular condition. Let's say we consider a four-bar mechanism, and in four-bar mechanism, that mechanism has, if you want, that mechanism is to have at least one revolving link, then what is condition? Means what? I taken one four-bar mechanism. We take one four-bar mechanism. In that four-bar mechanism, or in any mechanism, if you want at least one revolving link, then what is condition? That condition is given by Grashof's law. So what is that condition? The condition is, if some of the lengths of longest, or you can say largest, and the shortest link is less than some of the other two link lengths, then one of the link will act as a crank. I repeat, let's say consider a four-bar mechanism here. Of course, this now even though it is looking like parallelogram, but assume that the links are different in length. Let's say this one is shortest link, and let's say this is longest link. This is P and this is Q. Now what SLPQ is? S is shortest link length, L is longest link length, and P and Q are the two other link lengths, which is not shortest or not longest, but other two link lengths. So I just told you what is SLPQ that we consider in a four-bar mechanism. Now what is our condition? If in this mechanism I want one of the link as a revolving link, which will make rotation about a pivot point. Let's about this point. We know that all this link, all these pairs are turning pairs. Here also, you can see like this. All the pairs are turning pairs. Okay. So when all these pairs are turning pairs, and there are four links, then I can say, if I want one of the link as a rotating link, revolving link, then what is condition? I told you already. That condition is S plus L is either less than or equal to P plus Q. What is S? Shortest link length. L is longest link length. Other two link lengths are P and Q. So this S plus L must be either less than or equal to P plus Q. If this condition is satisfied, then only one of the link can act as a revolving link. Revolving link, generally revolving means it makes complete rotation. So in this case, this link made complete rotation, or it is act as a revolving link if this condition is satisfied. That is S plus L is less than or equal to P plus Q. Understand condition? And that link which makes complete revolution or complete rotation is called as a crank. Is this condition is clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear or not? What is condition to have a link, a revolving link in a four-bar mechanism? Please respond.
The sum of the shortest and longest link should be less than or equal to the sum of other two links.
Am I audible? Hello?
Yes.
Is this condition is clear or not? All of you please reply.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I think I'm not getting your voice. Can you write in chat box, because I'm not getting your voice. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now you are audible to me. Okay. So is this condition is clear? Condition of Grashof's law. When a link is to be a revolving link, or when you can say it is a crank. Clear or not? All of you. Please repeat one more time. Okay. See, I request everyone to respond, please, so that I'll understand whether you are getting or not. So this topic we have started today, yes, we are considering Grashof's law. Why, for what purpose Grashof's law is written? It is just to give condition to have a at least one revolving link in a four-bar mechanism. I already consider one four-bar mechanism. Let's say like this. Okay. Here there I consider different links like S, L, P, and Q. So what is S and L? S? What is S here? Hello.
Shortest.
So I request please respond. Okay, so that I'll understand whether you're audible, I'm audible or not, or whether you are getting or not. Okay. So S is shortest link. Next, S, L is
longest link.
And P and Q is
other two links.
Other two link lists. Okay. Now what is condition? Means in this mechanism there is shortest link, there is longest link, other two link lengths are there, and there you can say, in this case, in this four-bar mechanism, one link will act as a crank or a revolving. Crank means the link which makes complete rotation. That is revolving link. What condition is? To have a crank in a four-bar mechanism, our condition is this S plus L must be less than equal to P plus Q. What is S? Shortest link. L is longest link. P and Q are other two link lengths. If this condition is satisfied, then only one link act as a crank. That is simple Grashof's law. Is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, I discuss basic condition of U. Basic condition of Grashof's law with you. That is S plus L is less than equal to P plus Q. But now, based on this equation, the four-bar mechanism are classified into three types. That means based on Grashof's law, this equation, this four-bar mechanism is classified into three types. That is class 1 mechanism, class 2, and you can sometimes it's called a class 3 or also called as a special linkage. So class 1, class 2, class 3 are the classification of four-bar mechanism, or you can say four-bar linkage based on Grashof's law. Now what is this class 1, class 2, class 3 classification is, that we'll see later, that we'll see now in detail. So let's say first there is class 1. When a four-bar linkage is called as a class 1 linkage, the condition is if S plus L is less than P plus Q. So for a class 1, our condition is this S plus L is less than P plus Q. Now tell me, if this condition is there, S plus L is less than P plus Q, there will be crank or not in a mechanism? If this condition is satisfied, that S plus L is less than P plus Q, is there any crank or not in a mechanism? Are please reply. Is there any crank or not in this case?
Yes, sir. There will be because as it satisfies the equation.
Yes, it satisfies the Grashofta, or you can say it satisfies the equation, because what is our equation? S plus L is less than equal to P plus Q, either less than or equal to. If this condition is satisfied, then it is okay. There will be crank. And why we are saying this crank? Because remember, in earlier days, whenever machines were not, you know, invented and all, in that case, or in case of mechanism, they need some rotary link. Actually, rotary link is not there. Rotary motion is not there. They are just transparent sliding motion. So whenever means a revolution take place, they want some link should be rotated, transmit the motion to transmit the forces. So at that time they define this condition. Means when link will be rotated, the condition is this much. So it is very important to have rotating link in a mechanism, or you can say crank likewise. So, and that will be satisfied with this equation, S plus L less than equal to P plus Q. So in this case, as S plus L is less than P plus Q, so we can satisfy this is satisfying Grashof's law, and hence this is nothing but can say Grashofian linkage. So class one linkage can be called as a Grashofian linkage, as it is satisfied the equation, basic equation. Now class two is when S plus L is greater than P plus Q. Now tell me, is there any crank in this case?
No.
And hence this mechanism, that is class two, not mechanism I can say, but I'm saying class two linkage, is called as a non-Grashofian linkage. Class one is called as a Grashofian, class two is called as a non-Grashofian. And the second case, third case, when it is equal, actually it is Grashofian linkage as it is satisfying Grashof's law, but it is called as a special case of four-bar linkage. So we'll discuss now these three cases in detail. Any doubt till now?
No, sir.
Yes. Others?
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay. So this is what we talk about Grashof's law, its basic equation and three class equation basically. We'll start with one by one. That is, first class equation is class one four bar linkage. And I request everyone, you can make notes of this with your own, because theory topic, the first unit is near about theoretical topic, but it forms a basis for other units. So I request you make your summarized notes, or you can say short notes, but make your notes. And you attend your lectures with pen and notebook at least. I request you, and this is my request to you, so that you can remember the concepts in more details. Okay, so I told you already, the first classification, that is class one four bar linkage, and it is, the condition for this one is S plus L is less than P plus Q. As it satisfies Grashof's law, this also called as a, this linkage also called as a Grashofian four bar linkage. Now here, let's assume, let's see this diagram first. This is your four bar mechanism shown here. Let's say this is link A, then another link is D, this one is B, and this one is a C. I take this diagram as it is representing in a proper manner, even though nomenclatures are changed, but I think there is no problem to understand. So A, B, C, D are the four links. A, B, C, D are the four links. What is our condition here? Of course, this is satisfying this condition, means S plus L is less than P plus Q. Whatever the shortest link plus longest link length is less than other two link length. So here, in this case also, when it is class one four bar linkage, when that means when S plus L is less than P plus Q, again there are three different conditions are there, and three different cases we can obtain by fixing different links. Let's say the condition is satisfied, that is S plus L is less than P plus Q. And the first condition is, if we fix shortest link, which one is shortest link? In this case, example?
D.
So if we fix shortest link, that is link D is fixed. Okay, so if we fix this link D, then So when this link D is fixed, then you can see this link A as well as link C will act as a crank. Means I told you, okay, there will be one crank only when this condition is satisfied. So at least there will be one link, one crank. But when this condition is satisfied and we fix shortest link, Remember which link is also important. So when S plus R is less than P plus Q, it is Grashoppian linkage, class 1 linkage, and in class 1 linkage, if you fix the shortest link, that is link D here, then we obtain double crank mechanism. Now, why it is called double crank? Because when you fix this link number A, link A as well as link C will make complete rotation about point, this A will make revolution about this A, and this link C will make revolution about D. You can see this path of the rotation. So let's say this A, B, C, D, capital A, B, C, D is first position. Now tell me which one is second position here of the mechanism. Let's say this mechanism, I given some motion to the mechanism, link A is rotated through some angle and it is moving to now A to B dash, because A and D is fixed point, but B will move to B dash. You can see this path of the motion. B is moving from B to B dash, while C is moving from C to C dash. So our next position of mechanism is A, B dash, C dash, D dash. Not D dash, but it is D only. Is it clear, first and second position?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you can see this one is our second position. So this AB, which was initially here, is moving to AB dash. This one is B dash, C dash link. Link number 2, we can say, or link number small b. And this is C dash D. So this is your second position. Now tell me third position. Which one is third position? Yes.
B double dash.
It is B double dash. So you can see now here it is A. This one is A, B double dash. This one is B, B double dash, C double dash. And this is D, C double dash. So this is your third position. Well, one more position is shown here. I hope it is visible to all.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now see, this is fourth position. This is A, B triple dash, C triple dash. It is here, okay. Now you observe, when this mechanism is moving through different positions, let's say this is first position, this one is second position, this one is third position, and fourth. Likewise, we are rotating this mechanism, even though AD is fixed, but this link, you observe now, what is motion of this link A? It rotates, it makes complete rotation from AB to AB dash, AB double dash, AB triple dash, and again AB. So it makes complete rotation. So this link makes complete rotation, hence this link is called as a crank. Similarly, if you observe motion of C, link C, it also makes complete revolution about this point, that is about D, and this will make revolution about A, and hence this both links are called as a crank, and hence this mechanism obtained is called as a double crank mechanism. So when double crank mechanism is obtained, yes, what is condition?
Shortest link is fixed.
First condition is it must be a Grashoppian linkage. Means the condition of Grashoff's law must be satisfied, and it is nothing but S plus L is less than P plus Q. Remember, in online examination, now online examination will not be there, but we can't say anything about exam pattern now. If an examination is there, then online examination, the questions will be asked on this. Or in oral, questions will be on this topic. In examination like GATE, competitive examinations, you may try to attend for GATE. In GATE examinations, many questions are asked on theory of machine subject. Okay, so they will check your basic knowledge. In that case, you need this concept, basic concept. So what I said, when it is possible, first condition S plus L is less than P plus Q. And second thing, in that case also, even though S plus L is less than P plus Q, whenever a shortest link is fixed, we obtain double crank mechanism. So some mechanism is given to you and they will say this one double crank, single crank, or it is double rocker, like these options are there. You need to identify, okay, what is link length? Then you have to calculate whether S plus L means, suppose it is given, let's say some dimensions are given to you, 10, 15, 20, 30, something. Then you need to check whether this condition S plus L is less than equal to, greater than equal to, or I'm saying equal to. So like that, we have to check, and based on that we have to check again which link is fixed. So if link D is fixed, then I can say okay, this will be a double crank mechanism. Of course this part is important for design purpose. Means without actually drawing mechanism, without actually manufacturing mechanism, we come to know, okay, this will be our condition, this will give me double crank. So first one is clear, double crank mechanism is clear.
Yes sir.
Yes, so it is obtained when shortest link is fixed in a class 1 linkage. Now let's talk about other thing. Whenever a link adjacent to shortest link is fixed, now tell me which are the links adjacent to shortest links. Let's consider A, B, C, D are the four links. Yes, which is the link adjacent to shortest link?
A and C.
Yes, D is shortest link. So I can see, now you see, I can see this one is shortest link, that is D is shortest link. D is shortest link, A is adjacent to shortest link, C is also adjacent to shortest link, and B is link opposite to shortest link. Can I say like this? B is link opposite to shortest link. A and C are the adjacent links. So first we fix shortest link, we obtain double crank mechanism. Now when, suppose let's say instead of fixing shortest link, if I fix any link which is adjacent to shortest link, that is either A or C, then which kind of mechanism will obtain? So I repeat, when I fix a link adjacent to shortest link, that is either A or C is fixed, then we obtain crank rocker mechanism. Now how it is, we'll see here. So what I told you, our condition is that S plus L is less than P plus Q. First condition is satisfied. S plus L is less than P plus Q. Hence, if this condition is satisfied, I can call this mechanism as, or this linkage as, yes. What I call this as, yes?
Grasshoppian.
Of course, Grasshoppian, but in Grasshoppian, I can call it as class 1. Understand? There are three classifiers further, na? Class 1, class 2, and class 3.
Class 1.
So it is class 1. As S plus L is less than P plus Q. Now in this case, instead of fixing D, we seen about D now. When D means I'm saying shortest link. So when shortest link is fixed, when shortest link is fixed, we obtain double crank. That is known to you. But instead of shortest link, if I fix this any link adjacent to shortest link, let's say link A is fixed or link C is fixed, then which kind of mechanism is obtained? And that is just in front of you. So if, when I fix A, the shortest link, which was D, will make complete rotation. Will revolve about point of this. I'm saying will revolve about this point, about this center of rotation. It will revolve. So it makes complete rotation. So this will act as a crank. Now what about this link? Yes. Link P. Just focus on this first diagram, that is A. This link is rotating, crank is rotating, and this B wheel, I'm not saying it is rotating, but it will oscillate. Rocker. It will oscillate. It rocks. You can say rocker. So crank and rocker mechanism is obtained here. Means link adjacent to shortest link is fixed, then shortest link will act as a crank. And link opposite to shortest link will act as a rocker, while this link, that is C, will act as a coupler. So crank rocker mechanism is obtained. And here now, if instead of A, if C is fixed, then you can see the difference between these two diagrams. This A and B, what is difference between these two? Yes, observe it carefully. And what is difference? Any difference is there in the two diagrams, A and B?
Instead of A, C is fixed.
Good. Instead of A, C is fixed. Now tell me, what happens when I change that link, fixing link, fixed links? Instead of A, if I fix C, what is change in the mechanism?
D will act as crank. And okay. B will oscillate.
Yes. So you said D will act as a crank and B will oscillate, means B will act as a rocker. But same case here also. Here also D will act as a crank and B will act as a rocker. So any difference is there?
So I think so. The link which is at fixed has more length in B than in A.
Please repeat.
In A diagram, the link which is fixed has means A is shorter than C, and in this C is fixed and which is greater than A.
Okay, you are talking about dimensions. Okay. That's okay. Yes, please.
A is the coupler.
C is the coupler. Okay. Opposite will be coupler. Yes. Here A is coupler. Okay. Any other one micro observation is there? Whether center of rotation get change?
Yes.
Yes, here it will be anticlockwise.
Yes, means what happened? You observe here. Whenever this link A is fixed, of course, this D will rotate about a connection between D and A. Are you getting? So this one is center of rotation. If you observe carefully, I think this, I'm saying this one. Is it clear? So this link will revolve about this center of rotation. Are you getting or not?
Yes.
Okay. But what happened here? When link C is fixed, of course, this D will rotate about C. About C means I'm saying about this point. So center of rotation get changed. Are you getting or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So in both cases, even what is common thing here? Which link we fixed here? In both cases, common thing, which link is fixed? You can say in general.
D.
Adjacent to the shortest link.
Yes, D is not fixed. Once again, link adjacent to shortest link is fixed. See, naming don't remember. Maybe it is S, L, P, Q, A, B, C, D, P, Q, R, A, something it is. What you need to observe is which one is shortest link, which one is longest link, and which are the other two link lengths. So here in the first example, in the class one, first example, we fix shortest link. In second case, we are going to fix link adjacent to shortest link. Either it is A or it is C. So when A is fixed and when C is fixed, in both cases, we obtain which mechanism? Please speak. Which mechanism?
Crank rocker mechanism.
Crank rocker mechanism. So in both cases, we obtain crank rocker mechanism. But the difference is here. In the first case, of course, that crank will rotate about a fixed link. Not I'm saying about a fixed link, but one point. Where that crank is connected to fixed link, about that point it will rotate. So center of rotation is different in both cases, but of course both are crank rocker mechanisms. Okay, now third one, case 3. I'm not saying class 3, I'm saying case 3. So in case 3, our last condition here. Now see, in the first where we define link, that is shortest link. In second case, we define link adjacent to shortest link. If I fix a link opposite to shortest link, then which mechanism will obtain, that we'll see now. So which link we are going to fix now? Link opposite to shortest link. That link is nothing but B in this case. So if I fix link B, which is opposite to shortest link, then always, remember here, always we obtain, yes, observe it.
Double rocker mechanism.
Double rocker mechanism. This is an exceptional case actually. When link opposite to shortest link is fixed, then we obtain double rocker mechanism. No link will act as a crank. This is an exceptional case where even though it is S plus L, Grasshopper link is satisfied. That is our condition, but here it is not satisfied as we are going to fix link opposite to shortest link. So remember, it is a very important which link is fixed in a mechanism. Means in a designing, if you want, suppose particular link, we need to rotate. At that time, we need to think about dimensions. Okay, what are the dimensions? And if I fix these dimensions, what will happen? That we are going to judge if you have this knowledge. So I'm saying in class one, when link opposite to shortest link is fixed, we obtain double rocker mechanism. Here link A as well as link C will act as a rocker. Understand? Clear? Class one is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we'll go for class two now. Sorry. Now see, what is class 2 condition? Class 1 is S plus L is less than P plus Q. What is class 2?
S plus L is greater than P plus Q.
Yes. S plus L is greater than P plus Q. So when S plus L is greater than P plus Q, is it a Grashoppian linkage?
No.
Can you call Grashoppian linkage? No, it is not a Grashoppian linkage. So it is not Grashoppian linkage, and hence it is called a non-Grashoppian linkage. So as condition not satisfied, it is called a non-Grashoppian linkage. And remember, when it is non-Grashoppian linkage, if you pick any of the link, means either we pick shortest link, link adjacent to shortest link, that is A or C, or we fix link B, which is opposite to shortest link, whichever link we fix, in every case, we obtain double rocker mechanism, or sometimes also called as a rocker mechanism. Rocker means double rocker. Just in single word, single sentence, I conclude this. Understand or not? Whatever link is fixed, in both cases, always we get double rocker, as there is no crank. We know that for a crank, at least condition is, what is our condition? S plus L is either less than or P plus Q, less than or equal to P plus Q. But if it is greater than P plus Q, then we will not obtain any crank, and the mechanism obtained is rocker mechanism. Whether we fix A, B, C, D, anyone, we obtain double rocker only. Clear or not?
Yes.
Okay. So what you can say in this case, link opposite to fixed link will always become a, whatever link we are going to fix. Let's say suppose B is fixed here. So opposite to fixed link is this, that is D. So D will act as a coupler, and these two will act as a rockers. A will act as a rocker, and this C will also act as a rocker. Clear or not? Now tell me, if C is fixed, then which link is coupler?
A.
Okay. And these two are rockers?
B and D.
D. Okay, good. I hope you understand. So our case class 2 is S plus L is greater than P plus Q. That is non-Grashoppian linkage. And in non-Grashoppian linkage, we always obtain double rocker mechanism, whichever link is fixed. And last one now, that is special case of forward linkage. S plus L is equal to P plus Q. Of course, it is Grashoppian linkage, and hence there will be a crank. It is called a special case. So you can observe here, there are two cases basically. One is parallel crank four-bar linkage. As the name is parallel crank, so in special case S plus L is equal to P plus Q, we can take one example as parallel crank four-bar linkage. Here you observe the opposite links. How these two opposite links are? Let's say there are four links, A, B, C and D. Can see here, this one is A, B, C and D. How opposite links are there? That's how these two opposite links are. Observe opposite links. B and D are opposite links.
Parallel to each other.
Yes, please.
Opposite links are parallel to each other.
Yes. Only parallel. You're right. It is parallel, but only parallel.
Equal
and parallel.
Equal and parallel. So you observe here, A and C are equal in length. So A and C are opposite. They are equal in length and parallel. B and D, equal in length and parallel. So we can see, when two opposite links are parallel and equal in length, then if you fix any one of the link as a fixed link, or you can make any one of the fixed link, then in this case, we obtain double crank mechanism. Means either I fix A, then B and D will act as a crank. If I fix D, then A and C will act as a crank. So in this case, S plus L is equal to P plus Q. If opposite links are equal and parallel, then we'll obtain double crank mechanism. Sometimes also called as a parallel crank mechanism. That's what we written here. Links which are adjacent to fixed link becomes crank. You can see here. Which one is fixed link here? D is fixed. So link adjacent to fixed link always become crank. So which are the adjacent links? A and C. So here A will act as a crank, as well as C act as a crank. And you can see it makes rotation. Crank means it makes complete rotation. The circle is shown here. So it will act as a crank. So A and C, which are adjacent to fixed link, will act as a crank, and opposite link will become a coupler. And this mechanism is called as a parallel crank forward linkage, or can be called as a parallel crank mechanism. Remember, have you seen any application of this?
Yes,
called linkage.
Yes, please. You can see here it is used in coupled wheel of locomotives, in trains. This kind of mechanisms are used to transmit power to next wheel, motion to next wheel. Have you seen locomotives? Coupled wheel of locomotives. What do you mean by this? In which rotary motion of one wheel is transmitted to other wheel in same sense of rotation. Because of trains, you can see the how that linkages are there, wheel linkages are there. So it is parallel crank only. Means if I give motion to one, it will transmit motion to other. Getting or not? This example is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And the last one in Grasshopper linkage is deltoid four bar linkage. Now, when the linkage, that is special case of four bar linkage, of course, this deltoid linkage is only when this condition S plus L is equal to P plus Q. So in this case, this special case is called as a deltoid linkage only if the equal links are adjacent to each other. Now, the question in front of you, equal links means what? Can you tell me what is the meaning of this? Equal links are adjacent to each other. So in this case, let's say ABCD. Don't think the dimension as it is shown here because the diagram is compressed. And hence we can say there will be some variation in dimension. But what do you mean by equal links?
If D is fixed, then length of adjacent means A and C should be equal.
No. Equal links are adjacent to each other. You read the sentence carefully. Equal links are adjacent to each other.
Yeah, E and D will be equal or C and D.
Yes, it is. Means adjacent links are equal. And if adjacent links are equal, again there are two possibilities. Just go through these slides and tell me them. Because till now I just told you all, you read and tell me something. Try to understand. Let's say I can say it as, you can see, let's say it is this one is shortest link here. So let's assume that this is shortest link, this is longest link. D is shortest and A is, let's say, longest. So what happened now? Don't see the dimension here because dimensions are different, looking different, but let's assume it is shortest link D and A is longest link. Then adjacent links are equal. Means if it is A is longest, then A and B would be having same dimension and D and C is having same dimension. Adjacent links are equal. One is shortest, other is longest. So if S is shortest, L is longest, then P will be equal to S, Q will be equal to L, like that. Are you getting or not? Adjacent links are equal. And if adjacent links are equal, assume that these adjacent links are equal here as in dimension. And if adjacent links are equal and I fix shortest link. So if we fix shortest link, and even though in the case when adjacent links are equal in length, then we obtain double crank mechanism. So here you can see here, this A as well as C will act as a crank. But when double crank is obtained? Only when the shortest link is fixed. And if, when any of the longer link is fixed, let's say D is fixed as it is longest here now. When D is fixed, let's say D and C is equal and B and A is equal, then in that case, we obtain crank rocker mechanism. Because longest link is fixed, so shortest link will act as a crank. One of the shortest link will act as a crank. Other shortest link, that is B, will act as a coupler and the C will act as a rocker. So in that case, we obtain crank rocker mechanism when longest link is fixed. So in deltoid linkage, that linkage, when condition S plus L is equal to P plus Q, in the same time, at the same time, equal links are adjacent to each other. In this also, even though equal links are adjacent to each other, if I pick shortest link, then we get double crank. But if I fix longest link, then we obtain crank rocker. So this is all about Grasshopper linkages. Can you summarize this so that we'll end our lecture? Actually, instead of taking new point, just I'm going to summarize this. Yes, class one. What is condition for Grasshopper law first? Yes. We'll revise this.
L is less than S plus L is less than P plus Q.
What happens if S plus L is less than equal to P plus Q?
It is Grasshopper's link.
So Grasshopper linkage means exactly what?
Class one.
No, what I'm expecting.
Parallel crank.
S plus L is less than equal to P plus Q means in that mechanism at least one link will be. One link will be crank.
Revolving.
Yes, revolving link. Try to understand why what is Grasshopper's law? Basically, Grasshopper's law is condition to have at least one link as a revolving link in a mechanism. And that revolving link we called as a crank. Understand or not? So if you want at least one link as a revolving link in a mechanism, then the Grasshopper's law should be satisfied. And Grasshopper's law statement is S plus L is less than or equal to P plus Q. In the reverse way, you can say if S plus L is less than equal to P plus Q, then one link will be crank. Understand or not? Forget about class 1, class 2, class 3. When I just talk about Grasshopper's law, understand? Or yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So anyone tell me, means what is your understanding from only Grasshopper's law? Why it is needed? To define what? Yes, Grasshopper's law satisfied means what? Hello. Please speak. Okay, I revise it. Once again, Grasshopper's law satisfied means at least one link will be revolving link and that link is called as a crank. So if you want any link as a crank, then this condition must be satisfied. There are three classes, class 1, class 2, class 3. What is class 1? S plus L is less than P plus 2. Class 2 greater than P plus 2. And class 3 or special case nothing but equal to P plus 2. Now in class 1 again there are three cases. When shortest link is fixed, what you obtain? At least tell me that. Yes, when shortest link is fixed in class 1, which mechanism you obtain?
Double crank.
If link adjacent to shortest link fixed, that is either A or C is fixed, then you obtain?
Crank rocker mechanism.
Okay. And the last when? We fix link
double rocker mechanism.
We obtain double rocker mechanism. Good. In class 2, when S plus L is greater than P plus Q, then?
Double rocker.
We obtain double rocker. Whichever link is fixed, there is no restriction. Either you can fix A, B, C, D, then you obtain double rocker mechanism. And in class 3, special case, that is parallel crank four bar linkage. Yes, in this case, what happens when we fix any link?
Parallel crank mechanism.
Yes, parallel crank mechanism. And always you can see in this case, link which is adjacent to shortest link, or you can say link, not shortest link, I'm saying, link which are adjacent to fixed links will act as a crank. Both link will act as a crank, that is double crank mechanism. And that mechanism is called the parallel crank. In the last, deltoid linkage, here, deltoid linkage S plus L of course is equal to P plus Q, and we've seen equal links are adjacent to each other. And in this case also, when the shortest link is fixed, we obtain double crank, but when link that is longest link is fixed, we obtain crank rocker mechanism. This is all about Grasshopper's law. I request you, you have to draw all diagrams. Means you have to write case 1, case 2, case 3, and you have to draw diagrams. And I will upload this one, means assignment on Google Classroom. You need to upload that solution on Google Classroom. Case 1, 2, 3. Class 1, 2, 3, Grasshopper's law, and it's all cases. So you need to upload this assignment on a Google Classroom. Okay, is it clear? Grasshopper's law is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.